Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Stephen Lilley from Greencoat UK Wind. Stephen, very good to have you in the studio with us today.
Thank you. Good morning. Hi.
Good morning. You're up with your full year results. Take us through some of the highlights of 2023 for Greencoat.
Sure. So this year we've had some in the region of just over £400 million actually £406 million of cash generation, net cash generation, 2.1 times covered. Because of the strong cash flow, we've had NAV pretty resilient through the year, even with interest rates going up and a higher discount rate. Also, power price forecast coming forward, taking the NAV down. So been very resilient because of that high cash generation. During the year as well, we've concentrated quite a lot on capital allocation. I think that's quite important because for a number of reasons, the shares have been trading at a discount to net asset value. So we've increased the dividend for 2023 from the target 8.76 pence to 10 pence. That meant that we paid an extra £29 million worth of dividends because we could to shareholders. In addition to that, we've increased the dividend for 2024 by 14.2%, which took us to the magical 10 pence, if you like. Actually, it also took us to 6% return on NAV. And that was against, I guess, the 5.2% increase in RPI. So we've always promised to increase the dividend with RPI. We've done that 11 times. Apart from this year, we did it by 9% more than RPI, and we'll continue doing it with RPI going forward. In addition to that, we see the sort of forecasts of dividends over the next 5 years will be 2 times covered in projection over the next 5 years, even with an RPI linkage going forward on that. That then gives us a lot of focus on what we better do with, in terms of capital allocation, be it an extra £200 million to do acquisitions or to pay back debt or to buy a bit more shares. Very much depends on where we're trading going forward. In terms of acquisitions, we've done £821 million on 4 assets, all bilateral. we've done that very much in the context of what else could we do with that money. So they had to be very NAV accretive, and of 2 of the projects especially have delivered most of the £174 million of NAV accretion just in doing those 4 transactions. I guess return has gone up to 10% net to investors, where the share price is trading at the moment. It's probably even 12% net to investors. So that versus a 4% government gilt is obviously fairly significant. And then with the extra dividend that we paid for Q4, but in Q1, we've gone through the £1 billion dividend payment in the last couple of weeks. So 1017, I think it was, million. We've now paid to investors over the last 10 years, 9 months.
Yeah, so good news for your investors. Yep. I mean, interesting fact from the results, you generated 1.5% of the UK's electricity demand last year. 1.5% doesn't sound like a lot, but it is a massive amount in the context, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yeah, so we own about 7% of UK wind, and wind produces about a quarter of capacity, so one times the other gets you to the number you expect. So yeah, no, it's a large amount. 49 wind farms, a big amount of capacity. Actually, that's another thing. We went through 2 gigawatts last year as well. Not that, you know, that's an arbitrary number, it's two, but it's a, you know, it's a round number if you like. So 2007, we just sneaked over at the end of the year when Kitemuir extension came in.
So, and that includes the new wind projects that you brought on board. I mean, are you looking at expanding on the 49 wind farms you currently have invested in?
Yeah, so the current environment we see, and it's really sort of the acceleration through to the government targets for 2050. We see a lot of capacity being built out. We see ourselves very much being part of the ecosystem of helping new capacity built by owning operating capacity and then obviously recycling capital into other people who are going to build that. We think development and construction is a very different risk with a very different risk profile. So, you know, we see a market that there's plenty of opportunity in. At the moment we bought 4 projects this year. 2 of them were transactions we'd done back in the day, probably even back 2020, I think it was, South Carl, Kitemuir extensions. So they were built. Why they're worth more is that obviously power prices have moved in that period, so that's where the 174 million of accretion generally comes from. And then the other 2 projects we bought very much on bilateral bases from people that we know well. So, you know, do we see a lot of capability going forward? Yeah, there's a lot of capacity that's probably in the market at the moment. because we're trading at a discount to the net asset value, we can't raise money, so we can only do a limited amount of that, which is a bit frustrating. So I think we, we might see ourselves doing a little bit of disposals. We've also got £200 million of cash flow generally in the year to be able to go and do that. So we may just have to be a bit slow for a little while, but you know, us being nearly in the FTSE 100, market cap of £3.5 billion, sizable business, you know, we need to grow, you know, for this business, for the country effectively, for the capacity to get built out, because we are a recycler, we're a secondary market, we're capable of doing that. And I think because of the scale we're at, most of the transactions we see are largely bilateral.
Okay. I mean, you've already outlined your dividend target for 2024.
Yeah.
How's 2024 looking for the company so far, Stephen?
Fine. Power price is down slightly, but we're still really, 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 really well covered. We're generating pretty much on budget. February always seems to be a good month. We're just about closing February out. Extra day this year, it's fine. I think we're in about 50% capacity when I last left the office. February's been fine, it's been good.
Great. Okay. Well, Stephen, thank you very much for coming in and giving us the updates. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress.
Thank you.
That's Stephen Lilley from Greencoat UK Wind.